Just yesterday, Governor Whitmer signed off on $2.5 billion in COVID relief, but she left more than $1 billion on the table because that money required her to give up some of her emergency powers. So what's next? And is the governor even willing to sit down with Republican legislators to come to a solution here? Rod Maloney talked to the governor one-on-one today. Rod, how forthcoming was she about this?
Well, you know, it's certainly top of mind because it just happened yesterday. But, you know, she clearly wants to see the Trump administration COVID money distributed in Michigan. It's almost $2 billion. But she also refuses to budge on the emergency orders through the MDHHS, which is absolutely infuriating the legislature. So I asked her straight up, are you willing to sit down and negotiate?
We can't afford to play politics here. We have to negotiate.
The governor continues to exhort the legislature to release the remaining $2 billion sent by the Trump administration to Michiganders.
We've tried and invited negotiation from day one, and the legislature has not reached back. They send, you know, their own versions that are vastly underwhelming and not significant in terms of the kind of resources that are at our disposal that we could really deploy to help people. And so, of course, we'll continue to remain ready to negotiate.
The problem with that? The legislature says it's just the opposite. House floor leader State Representative Ben Fredericks of Owosso says it's been a very frustrating year.
And she, in effect, wants the funding and, you know, blank check and get out of the room. And I have constituents I represent, and I have voices that I feel have been silenced, and I have people that want a plan from this governor after a year on how we're getting out of this thing.
Despite that stalemate, the governor does see a bright spot on the horizon. And while a lot of seniors continue to wait, frustrated.
This is a moment where we're gonna see it exponentially increase in terms of numbers of people that have access to vaccines. And we're working with our local partners and we're trying to move as fast as we possibly can. So as soon as those vaccines ramp up more and get into our state, every one of our partners will see an equitable share ramp up in their jurisdiction as well.
Now, one of the things that keeps bubbling up here for the governor is the nursing home policy that she had last year and the numbers of deaths in those nursing homes. There is the possibility of some litigation, perhaps some prosecution here. And so I had a chance to ask her about that, and we're going to take up all of that coming up on Local 4 News at 6 o'clock. Back to you.
Yeah, and it's obviously, it's been a year. It's been up and down through all of this, Rod. Did the governor talk at all about maybe what she's learned during this crisis?
Well, you know, it's interesting the way she put it, because I asked her essentially, you know, if you could go back and change things, what would you? And the first thing she talked about was manufacturing N95 masks in the state of Michigan. She says, boy, that sure would have been a good thing for us to have been doing. You have to believe that perhaps she wants to see that happening in the future.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, Rod, thanks.